Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Shamasyan and I've been helping students get into med schools like Cornell, Vanderbilt, and UC San Diego for over 15 years. In this video, we're going to talk about how to get into medical school. More specifically, we'll look at four hurtful myths students routinely buy into that unfortunately sink their odds of getting in. I'll reveal the truth and secrets behind these myths and also leave you with three key take-home points that you can use immediately to reframe your understanding of med school admissions. I'll help you approach your undergraduate career the right way by covering foundational pieces of the med school admissions process, from academic requirements to extracurricular activities and admissions essays. After covering the basics, we'll spend some time discussing the best practices for differentiating yourself from thousands of other qualified applicants, paying special attention to the most common mistakes students make during this process. Medical school admissions is hard, but it's not complicated. The point here is that there is little mystery when it comes to getting into medical school. It's just that pulling it off is difficult. As an analogy, it's quite simple to understand how a baseball player hits a home run. He secures his feet in place, watches the ball the whole way through, and connects the ball and bat with as much power as he can muster. Of course, it's an entirely different thing to pick up a bat yourself and face off against the pitcher who throws a ball upwards of 100 miles per hour. Despite being a rather clear process, nearly 60% of applicants can't execute, failing to matriculate to any of the MD programs they apply to. In other words, most applicants don't get into a single school. Therefore, you need to achieve at the highest academic and extracurricular levels to secure one of the limited spots. Now, this take-home point comes with a caveat. While it's important to know medical school requirements such as what classes you need to take, it's as important to understand why medical school admissions committees or adcoms expect you to complete certain coursework, achieve at a high level, and engage in certain extracurricular activities. If you don't understand why, you'll be forced to follow the same path as others before you. In other words, you'll adopt a checklist mentality and look like every other applicant. Medical school admissions factors fall into the following categories: academics or stats, extracurricular activities, and qualities and personal factors. First, let's talk about academics. Your stats, GPA and MCAT score, demonstrate your level of academic ability for medical school. However, the story is a bit more complicated. Your GPA is perhaps the single most important factor in your medical school application. But because schools have different grading practices and prestige, interpreting GPA is not as clear-cut as you might think. There isn't a GPA conversion table that can convert a 3.7 GPA at Northwestern to the equivalent number at, say, Texas Tech or A&M. That said, there are some comparisons that are easier to make than others. Because medical schools do consider the strength and prestige of your institution, a 3.6 GPA from Columbia would be valued more than a 3.6 GPA from, say, UC Davis. To better address GPA-related variabilities across applicants, medical schools require the MCAT, which is a standardized exam. So related to academics, one question that I get very often is, what GPA and MCAT score do I need to get into medical school? The answer here isn't very obvious. While it's true that students with higher stats matriculate at a higher proportion than those with lower stats, there is no singular cutoff for your GPA or MCAT score that will guarantee admissions. There are students with 4.0s and upwards of 520 MCAT scores that don't get in. On the flip side, there are students with 3.4 GPAs and MCAT scores around 510 who matriculate into competitive med schools. This leads us into our first myth of the video. If you can achieve high stats, you're all set to get into a top program. The problem here is, as we just discussed, meeting some imaginary statistical threshold only tells adcoms that you can handle the academic rigors of med school. There is far more to a doctor than your academic ability. Your GPA and MCAT score say nothing about who you are, why you want to be a doctor, or whether you'll be a good one. This leads us to our first truth. You have to build a powerful, convincing, and consistent persona across your application materials that differentiates you from the rest of the applicant pool. While your academics set the foundation, they're certainly not enough. You need to build an entire application profile that will demonstrate your ability to handle medical school and your potential to be an excellent physician. Only then will medical schools consider investing such a coveted spot in their class on your behalf. With that, Let's move into the supporting details, your extracurricular activities. To reiterate, medicine is far more than scientific knowledge and academic achievement. Medical school adcoms look to your extracurricular activities to get a sense of how you spend your time outside the classroom, your efforts to get involved in the medical field, what you're passionate about, your commitment to service, and your overall leadership potential. This sounds like a whole lot to do, and it is. And while shadowing, volunteering, and research are important, the best applicants are those who select one or two areas and achieve at a high level in them. In other words, the best medical school applicants aren't world-class at every single one of these extracurricular activities. In fact, students who adopt that mindset tend to achieve mediocre heights when it comes to each of their commitments. Top med schools want to admit students who are world-class or best of the best at something. For instance, many of the students I've worked with who got into top 10 schools demonstrated a research specialty by consistently publishing their work in well-known peer-reviewed journals. Yet others founded and grew nutrition education initiatives for students in low-income elementary schools. Whatever it is, it's important to have a defining achievement that adcoms can clearly remember you by. This leads us into our second myth. Some extracurricular activities are inherently better than others. What I mean here is that you can be an elite applicant regardless of what you're passionate about. This should be liberating. To stand out, yes, you must be memorable, but you're much more likely to be remembered for being a superstar in one area versus doing a bunch of things reasonably well. And even if you are pretty good at a bunch of things, you'll still want to be truly excellent in at least one area. It doesn't matter if that thing is research or community health fairs or teaching initiatives for prisoners. Instead of constantly monitoring what others are doing and attempting to replicate their accomplishments, carefully evaluate your passions and what kind of impact you want to have on your community. Once you've found what you truly love, achieve at high levels to stand out from the rest of the applicant pool. Let's now move into the last major admissions category, qualities and personal factors. Adcoms see over 50,000 applicants per year, so they're familiar with students who have simply checked all the right boxes regarding academics and activities. They don't want to admit these students as they haven't done their due diligence in truly exploring why medicine is the right career for them. Instead, they want to admit students who have clearly demonstrated certain qualities during their pre-med years, such as compassion through activities like patient exposure and community service, and also a desire for knowledge by participating in research or completing an honors thesis. When thinking about how to spend your time, consider whether you're pursuing something just to please adcoms or whether you're doing it for yourself. The former will result in a cookie cutter applicant, and the latter will result in personal growth and an applicant that clearly demonstrates key qualities that society wants in every physician. In addition to qualities, there are also personal factors that come into play during your application evaluation. Medical schools want to train workforce that reflects the diversity of the population. Patients come from high income and low income backgrounds, ethnic majority and ethnic minority groups, from urban and rural areas, religious and non-religious individuals, and so on. Therefore, medical schools look to admit a diverse class of students. While personal factors like your ethnicity, sexual orientation, and familial income are outside your control, your coursework and extracurricular activities can serve as evidence of your commitment to serving a diverse population. This cultural competency goes a long way in indicating to adcoms that you'll effectively serve diverse patients throughout your career. Now that we've talked about the building blocks of a med school applicant, let's take a look at the application process itself. This brings us to take-home point number three. The medical school admissions process provides multiple opportunities for you to demonstrate to adcoms the breadth and depth of activities you pursued during your undergrad years. Many students believe that the medical school admissions process is limited in scope. This brings us immediately to myth number three, that is, your goal for your application is to discuss only your medically relevant activities and insights to show adcoms that you're a serious pre-med student. Many students fall into this trap and believe that they should only include medically relevant experiences in their applications. Unfortunately, these students focus too much on clinical and research experiences. They demonstrate a genuine seriousness about medicine, but they run the risk of dehumanizing their applications and coming across like the typical cookie-cutter pre-med robot. Again, upwards of 50,000 applicants apply to med school each year, and nearly every pre-med has some variation of clinical and research experiences. If those are the only experiences you're including, What will make you different? This brings us to our third truth. Your primary goal for your med school application is to discuss who you are, why you want to pursue medicine, and why you'll be a great physician. Communicating this message effectively will require more than simply discussing your research project on stroke recovery or your clinical experience counseling patients on weight loss. You'll need to demonstrate to adcoms your passions and how you've made an impact in your local community. Maybe that takes the form of telling them about your stint as an intramural basketball referee or as a pen pal for terminally ill cancer patients. Whether or not they're related to medicine, adcoms can glean key qualities from you when you discuss activities that you're genuinely interested in. On the flip side, there are students that take this advice overboard, which brings us to myth number four. You have to cover everything in your personal statement for admissions committees to get a good sense of everything you've accomplished. The problem here is that students feel the need to get absolutely everything across in their relatively short 5,300 character limit personal statement. By attempting to cover absolutely everything, your personal statement will read like a resume or a CV. It'll also read like a harder to follow version of your work and activity section. Moreover, your essay will not provide the level of depth adcoms are looking for. Remember take home point number three, that your entire application has enough space to demonstrate breadth and depth, only if you take advantage of every segment of the application. Don't feel pressured to get everything out in your personal statement. So this is where the concept of a scarcity versus abundance mentality comes in. In short, the typical applicant has a scarcity mentality. They try to cover everything in their personal statement, ending up saying a little bit about a lot of things. They worry that they have to mention certain points in their personal statement, or they'll run the risk of adcoms not knowing something very important about them. But the best applicants have an abundance mentality. They discuss a few points in depth, knowing full well that they will have more than enough opportunities to cover the wide array of experiences in depth across their application. Specifically, they may discuss their personal background and path to medicine in their personal statement, provide details about extracurricular activities in the work and activities section, let others brag about them through letters of recommendation, demonstrate fit with each school through secondaries, and let their personality really shine during interviews. Your end goal is to make sure that your application components are cohesive. Each part of your application should supplement the others, painting a convincing picture of why you will be an excellent physician. In summary, this brings us to our fourth truth. You have to cover all of your experiences across your entire application, making sure to discuss only the most relevant information in any given section. By integrating everything we discussed, I know that you'll approach your undergraduate career with a refined understanding of the foundational pieces behind the admissions process and have a better understanding of how the best applicants differentiate themselves. So let's recap our take-home points. Take-home point number one. Medical school admissions is hard, but it's not complicated. Take home point number two. Med school admissions factors fall into the following categories: academics, extracurricular activities, and qualities and personal factors. And finally, take home point number three. The med school admissions process provides multiple opportunities for you to demonstrate the breadth and depth of activities you pursued during undergrad and perhaps beyond. Let's wrap it all up with a summary of myths and truths I've shared with you today. Myth number one, if you can achieve high stats, you're all set to get into a top program. But in truth, you have to build a powerful, convincing, and consistent persona across your application materials that differentiates you from the rest of the applicant pool. Myth number two, one extracurricular category is inherently better than the other. But the truth is, instead of constantly monitoring what others are doing and attempting to replicate their accomplishments, you should carefully evaluate your passions and what kind of impact you want to have on your community. Myth number three, your goal for your application is to discuss only your medically relevant activities and insights to show adcoms that you're a serious pre-med student. But the truth is, your primary goal for your application is to discuss who you are, why you want to pursue medicine, and why you'll be a great physician. And finally, this brings us to myth number four. You have to cover everything in your personal statement for admissions committees to get a good sense of everything you've accomplished. In reality, you have to cover all of your experiences across your entire application, making sure to discuss only the most relevant information in any given section. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, you can do that here so you don't miss out on new videos. If you'd like to learn more about med school admissions, you can also click the link in the description to get a free copy of my book, How to Get Into Medical School, which contains all of the strategies we use to help students get into schools like Harvard, Stanford, Johns Hopkins, and UCLA. Again, thanks so much for watching. See you next time.